The focus of the inquiry will be the attacks on 14 UN-supported buildings in the Idlib region, a number of them hospitals. The Secretary General was careful to establish his legal right to call for the investigation, well aware that it would be questioned by a few Security Council members. Russia was quick to condemn the SG's decision.
But we think that it was a mistake. And we regret that there was a pressure on Secretary General from the part of the countries that really don't want to bring peace to Syria. There is a lot of fake news about this, a lot of fake situations, like the recent ones. So we doubt very much that this is for the sake of investigation. This is for the sake of blaming Syria and Russia of the things that we do not do.
Well, I fully respect the right of the Russian Federation to disagree with me, as I also respect the position of 10 other members of the Security Council that had the opposite opinion. I believe that this inquiry can produce an important result, and I can guarantee that everything will be done to make sure that this Board of Inquiry acts with full objectivity, not to prove anything, but to simply say what the truth is.
Earlier this week, the UNA chief, Mark Lowcock, raised the possibility that information provided by the UN was being misused by some parties. The UN director of Human Rights Watch has now addressed that directly. In a written statement, Lou Charbonneau says, and I quote, "The inquiry should determine whether Russia and Syria have used coordinates provided by the UN to target hospitals." He continues, "To be effective, the investigators should attribute responsibility for any war crimes and make their report public."
The push for transparency is another point of controversy in the already tense debate about this inquiry.
Mike Hanna, Al Jazeera, United Nations.